Okay, today we're going to explain one of the most difficult movements in karate. It's actually very simple, but most people think that it doesn't have any purpose at all. It's when you put two hands together at the side of the body, which people interpret that as somebody is attacking you from this way, I'm going to prepare myself then to move right here, and then attack the opponent from this way. But actually, this is a very useful movement, and it's all over the place in the Ishingu katas and all the katas in the Okinawan karate. And it's a very popular technique also. Once you see this video, I think it will change the way you see the kata. The problem with that movement is when it's done too fast, you cannot see at the actual movement itself. But the movement itself is this one. When you look at slow motion, it's this. Now, where in the kata you will find that movement? For example, in one sukata, once you go here and then move to the other side, the technique starts here and then move to the side. So this movement is connected to this one. When he grabs you, your opponent in front of you, you make a wrist lock right there, and then change right there. Then strike to the knee, and then to the body. Similar movement you will find in Sayuchin from here. Okay? Your hand goes here with the same technique. You grab, and lock, and then change over here, locking, and then breaking the joint. Another place that you can find a similar movement is at the beginning of my hatching, right there. Okay? He grabs you, you transfer your weight to your opponent, then locking the opponent. Okay? So, next time you see the movement, it has to be a wrist lock. Thank you.